I'm here with promising recruit Sam Hooper. And Sam, I've really enjoyed your form in recent times. Let's take a look.
Assesses the situation, hangs back from the man in front, showing off his silky smooth foot skills right there. Oh, the kids will love that one. Hooper props, keeps well clear of the boundary. Gee, that was great awareness. This kid's really going places.
And speaking of going places, Sam, any chance for a lift?
Okay.
He's a beauty, this kid.
We'll have a look at some of the players to watch in the TAC Cup a little later on the hour. But now let's catch up with Stephen Wells. Very rarely talks publicly, but the Geelong recruiting manager tells our list manager, Terry Wallace, just what the Cats look for in the system.
That's right. Those players have done a great job, and many of them have played in a couple of premierships or three premierships. And so we've been pleased with the way they've come through and developed, but it's an ongoing thing every year, no matter how good you've been or whatever stage you are in your club's tilt at a premiership, whether it be when you're on the bottom or at the top, you're just trying to improve every year. And those 2 years certainly had a big impact for us, though.
I'm fascinated with how each of the clubs runs its list management in a completely different manner. We've seen the Swans, who have gone out and tried to get players from opposition clubs and fast-track them into their program. Others have followed that system. To me, it seemed like Geelong, for a long period of time, probably Brad Otten's with the one exception that they went and got a big, strong ruckman, but have developed their own, and that's been sort of a strategy that seems to have been pretty consistent throughout.
That's right, Terry. We do have a principle, I suppose, of doing the best we can through the draft in bringing in our own players and developing them and hopefully having the basis of our team through that. If there's areas that we need to address, we'll certainly look at opportunities through other clubs. That's a philosophy, but it's also been forced upon us, I suppose, in the last 6 or 7 years a bit, in that we've had salary cap issues, trying to keep our own players, let alone get players from other clubs. And as you know, we've lost a couple of players like Gary Ablett and Shane Mumford and Brent Prismal, etc., that have moved on. And so we've had to try and find ways of replacing them without necessarily being in a position to go and spend a lot of money on players from other clubs.
Did that principle change at all last year? I mean, obviously, Rivers, McIntosh coming into the club, Josh Caddy a little bit different because he's a much younger player. Was there any sort of shift to that, or was it just those opportunities presented themselves?
I think it was a combination of both, Terry. We had, certainly with free agency coming in, we had done a lot of research as a club as to how we could use free agency to our advantage and to be prepared in case we lost players through free agency as well. So we were well prepared and certainly open-minded to free agents as a list management strategy. But certainly circumstances changed a little bit where, as some of our older players, the guys that have had some success, moved on from the club, were more in a position to be able to afford players from other clubs as well.
How important was it for your club? We speak about your role in selecting the players, but the development of your players. So to have your own standalone VFL team, to be able to work your own players through that system, how important do you think that's been in the process of some of these young boys?
It's been vitally important, Terry. We've always said that we'll maintain our own VFL team whilst we can, and it's a budget decision, a board decision to fund the development of the players, and having our own VFL team has proven to be very, very important in that regard. It's all right to bring players to a club, and the players that go to any AFL club have shown something at some stage or other to someone to have their name called out, but to get them into the club and then develop them is just so crucial. And as I said before, our coaches and medical team, high performance team, they just do a brilliant job in bringing along those young players.
Now, I want to take you back to 2006. Joel Selwood's there. Number one, did you think, what was it, pick seven? Did you think he would be there at pick number seven? And did you know he was going to become the player that he has become?
I was very excited going to the draft on that morning, thinking that we might be a chance to get Joel Selwood. Had a fair indication in the week leading into the draft from the other clubs about who was likely to go. You just hear things, and it was going to the draft, there was a real chance today that Joel Selwood or Travis Boak was going to be there. We would have been happy to pick either one of them as it turned out on the day, but having found out the night before that it was likely Travis was going to go, I was very, very hopeful that Joel was going to be there, because he'd shown brilliant credentials as a player and leader as a 17-year-old the year before his draft year. Didn't play much, only played three games, I think, in the draft year, but he'd shown enough the year before. And but to think he was going to be the leader and the player he is now and have the impact he had straight away, no, I haven't seen that too much before.
If you were speaking to some young players, and obviously we have a lot of the TAC Cup players watch the show, is there any little tip you could give them that might just marginally enhance their chances of being selected?
The thing we look for a lot, we try and analyse every aspect of their game and, as I said before, find out a lot about their character and personality from the people around them. But I think it's important for us that we see players improving in the areas that they need to improve over the course of a year. It gives us an indication that they've probably got a bit of a work ethic and they're willing to listen to their coaches and understand the game. They're smart enough to know that they can improve in certain areas and if they work hard, they will. Guys that aren't improving so much, we'd perhaps question whether that's going to be a trait for the future.
Stephen, look, thanks for your time today on Future Stars. And from the footy world, congratulations on everything that's going on and hope the success continues.
Thank you very much, Terry.